Welcome to This Week in Leadership Research, episode number 5. Each week, I share a recently published journal article on leadership research. My goal is to translate the most up-to-date leadership research to leadership practices that help you in your daily work. This week, I'll try to answer two questions. First, can we use facial appearance, such as facial width-to-height ratio, cheekbone prominence, and facial symmetry to predict whether someone emerges as an entrepreneur? Second, can we use facial appearance to predict firm performance? Those are questions posed in an article titled What's in the Face? Facial Appearance Associated with Emergence but Not Success in Entrepreneurship. The article was published in the Leadership Quarterly in 2022. The link of the article is in the description section below. There is an old adage, don't judge a book by its cover. In this article, researchers went against the conventional wisdom to test whether we can judge entrepreneurship by someone's facial appearance. Specifically, the researchers examined three of the most extensively studied measurable characteristics that reflect facial geometry: facial width-to-height ratio, cheekbone prominence, and facial symmetry. What's the rationale and theoretical argument that support the potential connection between those three facial features and entrepreneurship? First, facial width-to-height ratio is derived from measuring the width of the face and dividing this measurement by the length of the mid-face. This is how we measure the facial width-to-height ratio. Horizontal lines represent the distance between the upper lip and the highest point of the eyelids. Vertical lines represent the maximum distance between the left and right facial boundary. The facial width-to-height ratio is calculated as width divided by height. There may be measurement error when we work from photographs in historical studies due to facial expressions. Men's facial width-to-height ratio has been found to be associated with prenatal testosterone exposure, adult testosterone levels, dominance, aggression, risk-taking behavior, short-term attraction, and CEO success. Men with greater facial width-to-height ratio were more likely to exploit the trust of others. Also, men with greater facial width-to-height ratios were more likely to explicitly deceive others in a negotiation. In one study, researchers collected pictures of 1,136 CEOs from S&P Composite 1500 companies in 2009. They reported that the facial width-to-height ratio of male CEO was related with the probability of financial misreporting. The odds of a high facial width-to-height ratio executive being accused of fraud were 11.75 times higher than the odds for a low facial width-to-height executive. The researchers concluded that the facial width-to-height ratio measures a distinct managerial trait. You may wonder, what men's facial width-to-height ratio have to do with behaviors? One possible mechanism for the connection is that the hormone testosterone influences both the development of the face shape and behavior. One explanation is that testosterone exerts effects on the brain both prenatally, that is, during fetal sexual differentiation, and during puberty. Testosterone also regulates the adolescent growth spurt in the presence of growth hormone. In particular, testosterone administration causes craniofacial growth in adolescents. Some research suggests that at puberty, the growth trajectories of men and women diverge for zygomatic width, which is the distance between two cheekbones, but not for upper facial height, which is the distance from upper lip to the highest point of the eyelid. The amygdala, which are a cluster of neurons that play a role in the processing of memory and emotional reactions, is particularly seen as the mediator between testosterone and other brain regions involving in evaluating complex social interactions. The amygdala has neurons expressing androgen receptors for testosterone. These vasopressinergic neurons in the amygdala may respond to testosterone by reducing communication to the orbital frontal cortex and increasing communication with the brainstem systems. The amygdala activity activates defense responses to interpersonal provocation and status threats, reduces interpersonal trust, and lowers the ability to self-regulate, which in turn give rise to behaviors of aggression, egocentrism, risk-seeking, status-seeking, and status maintenance. An important caveat to this body of literature should be noted. It is still a matter of debate, since we don't know the exact mechanism of how testosterone plays a role in the link between men's facial waist-to-height ratio and behavior. The exact causality of the relationship is not yet fully understood. I also need to point out that the facial waist-to-height ratio is only a valid measure of masculine behaviors in men. What about the relationship between men's facial waist-to-height ratio and leadership? One study showed that male CEOs of US and German companies had higher than normal facial waist-to-height ratio, while the CEOs of non-governmental organizations and leaders of the Roman Catholic Church have higher facial waist-to-height ratio compared to controls. Similarly, male CEOs of UK companies had higher facial waist-to-height ratio than age and sex matched the controls. Therefore, there is some suggestive evidence men with a higher facial waist-to-height ratio are more likely to emerge as leaders across various leadership contexts. One study examined the United States presidents until Reagan and their achievement drive, which was rated by research participants based on numerous historical texts. Researchers reported that the American president's facial waist-to-height ratio was a predictor of their achievement drive. There was also a report of a positive association between a firm's financial performance and the CEO's facial waist-to-height ratio. Since entrepreneurs are individuals who emerge as leaders of a business, it is possible that the facial waist-to-height ratio is also associated with entrepreneurship emergence. The second facial feature investigated was cheekbone prominence. It is the ratio of cheekbone width divided by jaw width. We've already known that cheekbone prominence is associated with attractiveness. Higher, wider cheekbones and narrower cheeks are related to greater perceived attractiveness. This association appears to exist across cultures among Asians, Blacks, Hispanics, and Whites. Facial attractiveness has been associated with higher perceived leadership ability. Attractiveness also has important effects for entrepreneurs because in attempting to start new ventures, they often interact with individuals who don't know them and who have little information about their potential, for example, investors, customers, and employees. Attractiveness also has important effects for entrepreneurs because in attempting to start new ventures, they often interact with individuals who don't know them and who have little information about their potential, for example, investors, customers, and employees. In situations where individuals are not previously acquainted, the effects of personal characteristics, including physical attractiveness, tend to be maximized. Since first impressions, which are strongly influenced by attractiveness, tend to persist, and it can strongly influence subsequent behavior and decisions, the impact of individuals' attractiveness on entrepreneurship emergence is likely to be considerable. The effects of a person's attractiveness in entrepreneurship have been shown in a variety of settings, from more favorable treatment of their ideas to higher perceived competence. In the wider business context, highly attractive people earn 20% more and are promoted more frequently than people of average attractiveness. Therefore, researchers hypothesize that cheekbone prominence is positively associated with entrepreneurship emergence and their firm performance. The third facial feature is facial symmetry, which means the left and right parts of the face look alike. Numerous studies show that facial symmetry is significantly correlated with physical attractiveness. We tend to view symmetry in faces as attractive. This association is probably mediated by our judgments of health. We tend to view people with symmetrical faces have greater emotional and psychological health. Attractive people are more likely to be trusted, receive more favorable evaluations of their business ideas, and more likely to become entrepreneurs. Also, the attractiveness of entrepreneurs has been positively related to their firm's financial performance. This may suggest an association between facial symmetry and entrepreneurship emergence and firm performance. Taken together, the researchers wanted to know whether the three facial features can predict whether an individual emerges as an entrepreneur and whether this individual's organization is high-performing. The existing literature suggested such a connection between facial features and leadership. Given many conceptual overlaps between leadership and entrepreneurship, the researchers hypothesized those connections should exist when it applied to entrepreneurship, but the hypothesis have to be tested by data. To do so, the researchers collected pictures of thousands of white male entrepreneurs and non-entrepreneurs. Entrepreneurs were the ones whose job titles contained the terms entrepreneur, founder, co-founder, owner, or co-owner. After data processing and using convolutional neural networks, results suggest that only two facial features, cheekbone prominence and facial symmetry, were associated with whether an individual emerged as an entrepreneur, and none of the facial features predicted the organizational performance. How to interpret the findings? Attractive individuals who have prominent cheekbones and symmetrical faces are more likely to emerge as entrepreneurs, but their attractiveness doesn't say anything about effectiveness or job performance. Their attractiveness may make them more likely to be trusted and get more attention from investors, which leads to their emergence as entrepreneurs. But substance works a long way. I wouldn't suggest you getting cosmetic surgery to have prominent cheekbones and symmetrical faces. Instead, I suggest you focus on improving your leadership skills. Researchers also discussed their findings that a higher facial width to height ratio is not associated with entrepreneurship, even though the existing literature suggests the association between facial width to height ratio and competence, dominance, and explicit achievement motive. It is possible that the facial width to height ratio is related to a stereotype of bigger, heavier men and is just a mediator of social impressions. Again, an attractive face or body may help you get people's attention and put a halo on the top of your head, but your competency is still what matters in the long run. If you're a researcher, I hope the article I introduced today can offer some inspirations for your research. If you're a leader or aspire to be a leader, I hope the articles can guide you in your leadership practices. Stay open-minded, get inspired, and never stop improving your leadership skills. I'll see you next week in This Week in Leadership Research.